All right. Good morning and or afternoon. Welcome back. All right. So yesterday I challenged you to take a shot at this problem. If you did not do it yesterday, come on, go ahead, pause this, give yourself a couple of minutes, give it a try. I'll wait. All right. If you went ahead and did it, excellent. If you did not, you are selling yourself short, guys. You gotta learn this material, and practice, practice, practice is what helps. So, okay, how much work to move the small charge from position A to B? That means we need to know what the voltages are at those two locations. So, to find out the voltages at those locations, we know it's KQ over R for each one. So that positive 2 microcoulomb, it creates an electric potential at position A is KQ over R, where R is 0.3. And it creates an electric potential at point B with KQ over R, but that R is going to be 0.6, so it's going to be a smaller value there. Negative charge will do the same thing from its position, but it's going to be a negative value. So your position at B should end up a bit negative, and your position A should be slightly positive. So we plug in our values. Ours are 9 times 10 to the 9 is our K. The Q is 2 microcoulombs. Remember, micro is times 10 to the minus 6. We do those calculations for point A, and you get a net voltage of 30,000 volts. Because you've got the positive from this guy and the negative from that guy. All right. If you do the same math for point B, same KQ over R, KQ over R, but now we're just changing the numbers with a larger negative and a smaller positive, and you end, sorry, I should, let me rephrase that. It's not a bigger negative, it's just the negative's closer. You end up with a negative 30,000 volts. It should be kind of logical, since it's symmetrical. Whatever this value should be the same, just a negative value. Okay, so now we know our initial, because we're starting at A, our initial is 30,000 volts, our final is negative 30,000 volts. Work is change in voltage times Q. Remember, the change in voltage is final minus initial. Cannot stress that enough. So final is negative minus initial, which was a positive. So a negative minus a positive gives you a really, really big negative change in voltage. You're going to a negative, going from a positive to a negative. It's a negative change. Multiply by the small charge that's doing the moving. That's not 2 microcoulombs, it's 0.5 microcoulombs. So we multiply that 0.5 microcoulombs and we get 0.03 joules. Notice it is a negative 0.03 joules, because it was a negative change in voltage. And also think of it conceptually, that positive charge is going to want to move away from point A towards point B, because the electric field goes from left to right in that area. Remember, electric field goes from positive to negative. So it's really the field doing the work, not us. So if we had to apply a force to keep it from accelerating away, our force would be to the left to kind of keep it in check while we slowly moved it to the right, and we end up doing negative work. All right, so that's how you do this kind of thing. You've got to find the voltage at multiple locations, and then your work is change in voltage times the charge that's doing the moving. If we were picturing that three-dimensional image again, you've got your hill where you got the positive 2 microcoulombs creating a positive electric potential. You've got the valley, that negative 2 microcoulombs creating that negative voltage down there, and your charge is going to go downhill because it's positive charge. If we were moving a negative charge, we'd have had another minus sign in that formula. Go back and look at it again, and you'd see we would have ended up with a positive work, because the electric field would be trying to move it uphill because negative charges go the wrong way, and would be pushing it downhill, therefore doing positive work. All right, that's the kind of problem we're looking for. There's your 30,000 volts there, negative 30,000 volts there. Those dashed lines would be your equipotential lines at that location. All right. And of course, negative work means work was done by the field. And in this case, that positive of charge going from A to B was the electric field doing the work. If we had just let go of it and let it accelerate going from point A to point B, that potential energy that it lost would have gone to kinetic energy. All right, and there's your master of the ceremony here at our Big Top Circus.
Used to Google answers. You used to. lances on your cell phone. 89 lances on your cell phone.
So here's a fun problem that was actually come up with by some AP students quite a few years ago. They said, hey, Mr. Medic, what if you had a Coulomb gun? I'm like, what's a Coulomb gun? They said, well, what if we took a piece of PVC, and it was 1 meter long, and in one end, we put that little Coulomb charge. Remember that little thimble full of protons or electrons we talked about before with the battleships? So let's take one Coulomb of charge, put it at one end of this piece of PVC, and then put the same kind of charge over the other end of the PVC, and then cap both ends and put a trigger so you can like open up one end, and they repel each other. I'm like, wait. So you want to put one Coulomb at one end, one Coulomb at the other? And they said, yeah. So, okay, well, remember it lifted 10 battleships out of the water? And it's like so many newtons, you know, 9 times 10 to the 9 newtons of force. It was just this ridiculous force. They said, yeah. And I said, how can you do that with PVC? And they said, we'll make it a really strong PVC. I'm like, oh. Okay, so we have this really, really strong piece of PVC, and we got the one Coulomb charge in both ends. And they say, hey, and if we let loose that one Coulomb, and we're shooting a target 20 meters away, how much energy does it have when it hits that other target? And all sorts of calculations from that. You know, how fast is it going? Things like that. I said, well, okay, but think about what we learned a while ago about action-reaction pair. So if this thing's doing all that force in that direction, then it's doing that same force back on the PVC on your shoulder. And they said, okay, well, like a shotgun, better hold that PVC really solid to your shoulder so you don't get any kickback. I'm like, uh-huh. Okay. Yeah, we'll do that. All right. So assuming you can brace your feet really well and this thing doesn't take your arm off when that PVC recoils in the direction, and it would, but we'll skip past that. So we'll say Superman is shooting our Coulomb gun. We want to figure out all those numbers. Like, okay, great. Let's go ahead and do this totally ridiculous problem. So, okay. So, here is our Mr. Zarzak. All right. So, he's going to shoot the Coulomb gun at Mr. Medic, who, of course, is just a paragon of kindness and goodness. All right. And I'm 20 meters away from this end. All right, so we need to figure out that whole change in energy. How much kinetic energy, potential energy, in other words, how much work is done on it? What's the change in voltage times that charge? So that means we need the voltage here and the voltage here. Okay, we can do that. So, okay, we could have done it the other way. But of course, we know that's not how this would go, right? Of course. Okay. So, yeah. So, we need the voltage at 21 meters away, because remember that one Coulomb sitting against the shoulder is not going to move, and that's 1 meter from the other end, which is still another 20 meters to the target. So, technically, we're going from 1 meter away, end of the PVC, to 21 meters away, where the target is. Okay? So, we need to find the voltage at those two locations. Oh, maybe I shouldn't have gone that far. Ah, gave you all the answers. Okay. You looked at them. You didn't memorize them. Pause the video. Give it a shot. I know you could have gone forward and looked at it, but still, hopefully you gave it a try. So, you know, your voltage of those two locations, you'd have your 1 Coulomb times K divided by 1 meter. That's going to be 9 times 10 to the 9 volts. That's a lot. And the other one, 21 meters away, you would divide that 9 times 10 to the 9 divided by 21. Multiply that by the charge. Remember, in this case, it's an entire Coulomb being launched. So here's your final voltage minus initial voltage. There's your 9 times 10 to the 9 divided by 1. 9 times 10 to the 9 divided by 21. Multiply by your charge of 1 Coulomb. And we get about 8 times 10 to the 9 joules worth of energy. Remember, it only started with 9 times 10 to the 9. So most of that energy is gone. Most of that energy is converted to kinetic in that first 20 meters. And that's how the math is going to work. So that's how much energy, how much kinetic energy the object has when it hits the target. it's how much potential energy it lost. Now notice it only lost 8.57 times 10 to the 9. It had 9 times 10 to the 9, so it still has some potential energy left. And it's going to use that potential energy to keep speeding up as it moves out to a distance of infinity. Because trust me, with that much energy, that target's not going to stop it. There's no target left. So we could also calculate how fast it's going. So if we look at the kinetic energy, you've got that 8.57 times 10 to the 9 joules of kinetic energy. Remember, kinetic energy is always positive. So it lost that much potential. It gained that much kinetic. That's why it's a negative here and a positive here. Set that equal to your 1/2 mv squared. And we'll say it's a kilogram just to make the math easy. And you get really, 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 really fast. Huge amounts of speed. Remember, it was only traveling 20 meters. So if its average speed was, say, approximately half that, yeah, it covered that in a millisecond. So boom, target's gone. What if it kept going? Well, it still has some potential energy left. It's got 9 times 10 to the 9 minus this. So it's still going to have some potential. And that will also go to kinetic. It'll end up with a final kinetic energy of 9 times 10 to the 9. We could plug that into our 1/2 mv squared and find the final velocity, which is going to be a little bit faster than that, but not a huge amount more. We do have the best toys. And unfortunately, this demo actually had a really cool toy for us to show and play with. And of course, we don't have it because we're home and you're home. So, toys sitting in the door. So sad. All right. So we're going to get some SRT practice. Now it's going to be a Socrative. And of course, can't find the link, but that's okay. I'm going to pause this here while I get myself set up, and then we'll get you set up. All right, so we should be about 15, 18 minutes into today's lesson. So plenty of time to do this next part. So you got these.
Century, doing something new to talk, doing it better than anybody ever seen, doing screams from the haters, got an ice cream to it, I guess every target tells you so, clean music, pulling sheet of paper, should have all that power, taking tons of stuff, I just cut down the hours, stop tripping, I'm tripping off the power, target tellers.
Alright, so here's what we got. We've got a Socrative. So we'll have the Socrative up and running. But rather than just cut you loose on it, let me explain what's going on here. So here we've got a bunch of different plates with different voltages on them. So you've got some high potential, you've got some low potential. Again, think of the uphill and downhill kind of idea. So on the left you've got negative 10 volts, that'd be down in a valley. Between that and a little bit to the right you see a negative 5 volts. Still a negative voltage, still a negative potential, but it is more positive than the negative 10. Therefore, it is a higher potential. Remember, negative charges, they go uphill. They go from low potential to high potential. So that negative charge would go uphill if we let go of it. It would accelerate toward that negative 5. I get that it's a negative voltage, and negative charges don't like negative charges. I get that, but the negative 10 is a bigger negative. So it will be repelled by the negative 10. Even when it gets super duper close to that negative 5, it's still going to be pushed toward that negative 5. Don't think it's going to get really close and stop. It's not how it works. The electric field goes from high potential to low potential, surface to surface. So that means that electric field goes from the negative 5 volt to the negative 10 volt. It does not matter that it happens to be negative and that's a negative charge. It will still be pushed all the way to that negative 5 volt plate. Now there's a hole in that negative 5 volt plate, so it'll build up speed, make it to that gap, go through that gap, and continue on. Now notice the first question is, what's the kinetic energy when it reaches that second plate? That's that negative 5 volt plate. The negative 10 is the first plate. So your multiple choice question is, how much kinetic energy does it have? Here's a hint, that's how much potential energy it's lost. So you're looking at the change of potential energy from the negative 10 to the negative 5. The next couple of questions will continue to ask things like this as it moves to the right, what various kinetic energies it has. Those should be detailed on the Socrative. So I don't think I need to go through the various pages after this. look at the next electric field between the negative 5 and the positive 2. It is still an electric field to the left, going from high potential to low potential, so that negative charge will continue to experience a force to the right. But then notice the next region between the positive 2 and the next negative 5. Now the field's to the right, which means the force on the negative charge is to the left. So it'll slow down, but will it slow down enough to stop, or will it keep going and make it through that negative 5 volt and reach that really strong electric field off to the right? We don't strong because the arrows are so close together. And once it gets to that region, if it gets to that region, notice that field goes to the left, so the force on the negative charge will be to the right, and it will accelerate again if it makes it that far in the first place. And those are the questions that the Socrative will ask. And this kind of shows you, here's that third plate, there's the fourth plate, and then if we remove the middle plate, which is a 2-volt one, does that change the answer? That's a yes, no. And then question 5 is if it is a slightly different system here. We're shooting a positive charge in instead. So think what a positive charge would do as that electric field, the first one here is to the left, it'll slow down. Here it speeds up. Here it slows down again. Will it make it all the way to the positive 10, or will it run out of potential energy? And this is asking how far it goes. That doesn't ask distance. It's what voltage will it make it to. Will it make it to negative 5 volts, negative 10, negative 1, positive 3, positive 9, all the way to the 10 volts, etc. Here's a hint. It's not going to make it to the 10. It will stop somewhere in this region, and I'm asking to find out what voltage it will stop at. So it'll go through a change in electric potential based on the change potential energy, based on how much kinetic it started with. When it runs out of kinetic, what potential is it at? All right, so that should take you, and then I'd ask you a second question with more energy. I know, it's a bit of work, but this is where talking to your teammates, talking to your classmates, emailing me. All right, this is an honors level question. This is what I want you to be able to do. So this should take you through the rest of today's class period. We will pick up a few other practice things and some Web of Science tomorrow. Have a great afternoon.